What is up, guys? Beancrew49 here. We are back on the Gaia community server, and Gaia rolls along. That's right, guys. We're getting back into the swing of things. The server is open for people to come. I think that's a new person. Yes, it is. What is that down there? What the heck is that? It's a skelly on a horse? Oh, two of them? What the? Oh, they're shooting at me. They shot first. It's on. Okay, well, there's two dead skellies. Can you ride those horses now? I wonder. I don't have a saddle, though. Is that how you get those things? Imagine three of them. Oh, you can. Oh, I don't have a saddle. That's right. Dragon Slayer from... Look at the health on that thing. Dragon Slayer from New Eden is selling these. He's got a business already. And he's selling those, so I don't need one. But man, that's interesting. I didn't know about this. We got an airline pilot in the server. Interesting. So, what was I talking about? That's right, we're getting into the swing of things, guys. We're getting back into the Gaia motions. And we're having a lot of fun working together. Or some of us working against each other. I don't know. We're a community of individuals, right? And Sage and Sage Landia are... No XP left behind. Sage and Sage Landia are getting a full steam ahead treatment. They're busting their butts. Made by Xbox and Sage. So they're getting their shop set up. And my, how much work they've done. First, we got the Xbox man's Mesa shop. Stained clay. Ooh, red sand. A lot of it. More red sand. Red hardened clay. I think he needs to stock it a little bit more. But he's got some things. Oh, he's got a lot of things in stock. Orange hardened clay. What's the prices on these? You got prices here, Xbox man? I'm sure he do. Let's see what we got here. Xbox man, Mesa shop. Four diamonds for stand. Four diamonds per stack for sand. And two diamonds per stack for clay. Not bad. Pretty good prices, I must say. What else we got here? We got Dat Mushroom Shop Fam. This is Dat Mushroom Shop Fam. Okay. Very well done. I like the look of it, the aesthetics. And he's got nothing. They got nothing. No, they got mushrooms. Oh, baby. Look at them mushrooms. I hope he's charging better than Stormzik's prices. Oh, do you guys remember Stormzik's gouging prices? Price gouge. Two stacks for two diamonds. Yes, for both red and brown. G, keep it fresh. B. Oh, that's cool. Two stacks for two diamonds. That's like cutting Stormzik's prices in half. Stormzik's had outlandish prices, but that Mushroom Shop fam, they got some nicely priced items. So very good. Oh, I'm in the back of a future store. Okay. Let's not go back there. Just looking around, see what they got done here. Every time I come over here, there's some new advancements. Did you guys just see one of them horses? It got it all covered off. Ah, they already got one. I don't know if I was supposed to see that. Oopsies. All right, so again, my inventory's full. Oh, I got a lot of book and quills. Remember I was talking about I need to buy 78 book and quills? Well, I had my first interaction with Sage Landia. I made a trade with Xbox Man to get these book and quills. I'm not going to tell you what I paid because, quite frankly, I don't want people to know what I be paying for things sometimes. So that's the shops. The market's looking nice. IGL Zenix and Zenland are coming along nicely. I looked at his shop last episode, I believe. I don't know what this guy's doing over here. Oh, IGL Zenix has been working on the bottom floor of the skyscraper. That's right, he took some donations and he volunteered to work on the bottom floor to get this community started. Thank you, IGL Zenix, for taking the initiative for that. I really do appreciate it. I don't think he quite finished. I think he's awaiting some more donations. But yeah, I really do appreciate it. I'm trying to get him to build my floor. I want to pay him some money. I want to pay him to build my floor. I mean, it's already partially done, IGLC. Name your price, man. I'll supply all the materials. You just supply the labor. No time. You can do it on your own time. And we'll discuss a flat price. Which brings me to what I want to do today. So what I want to do today is head on over to New Eden Lands. New Eden Lands. Because I want to work on something over there. I've rambled on long enough. I don't know if I'm going to have time to even do what I wanted to do. So let's go over there quickly and quick, fast, in a hurry. I like the new door system, but I think he's going to do a piston door thing. That's what he mentioned. He mentioned something about piston doors, so I don't know. We'll see. All right. Tuna Weedon and beyond. So far, so good as far as Sage leading Sagelandia. No problems. Oh, wait, there was a problem. I forgot about that. Do I need to talk about that on camera? I don't know. He accidentally killed somebody in his country. That's what he claims. I don't know. It seems like these accidents follow Sage around, but I believe him, actually. I mean, but why was he swinging his sword in the first place around another person? I don't know. So you can hardly call it an accident. It's like, you know, I was playing with this chainsaw and I accidentally cut the dude's head off. It's like, why were you swinging a chainsaw next to a dude in the first place, right? That's the sort of thing that happened over there in Sagelandia. So a lot of Sagelandia residents are a little bit on edge about that. They figure that it could happen to someone, it could happen to them. All right, so let's go in here because I wanted to show you what I got. I did some, sorry, I messed that up. I did some cool stuff over here. Some stuff that's gonna really help the New Edenites. So I made this track over here. So we got Cactusville 1, Cactusville 2. We got two rails in case, you know, someone's coming, someone's going, or in case we want to ship cargo while we're riding the rails. So we got two of those, but I also made a Mount Eden City. Oh, I don't know. I remember in last episode I asked you for a name. I didn't get any names. So I just called it for now Mount Eden City, but it could be Mount Edenville or something. That's going to take us here. And this is all a work in progress. It's not going to look like this, but we're in Mount Eden now with all of its skylights. So why so many skylights? I don't get it. Got this little hole here. I'm working on some redstone. I don't want to show you the redstone. You don't need to see the redstone. All right. So you guys remember this. No advancements here. This is what I want to work on today. Do I have the... Oh, no. Where's my red brick? Hold on. Hold up. Wait a minute. Let me put some boom in it. Let me drop these books off where they need to go. These books are going to be used for some tarot readings, but I can't use them until I get like 78 of them. And now I got 6. So there's a ways to go. But it doesn't mean I can't do tarot readings. If you guys on this server want a reading, I'm open for business. You want to see what, let's see, make an appointment here. Here's how it's going to go down. Check this out. Welcome to Bean's Tarot Reading Service. Here I can answer questions you have regarding Gaia and the people in it. Each reading will consist of a 3-card draw from an actual tarot deck and will be read by me, an actual tarot reader. The price per reading will be 8 diamonds. If you would like to schedule an appointment, write your name on the next page and let me know you did so. Thanks. Appointments. And then you just write your name and I will schedule an appointment with you. And that's how you can get on the list. And remember, guys, you can ask me anything. As long as it pertains to Gaia, you can ask me any questions. And I will use tarot, which is a system of divination. It's a psychic thing. I use my psychic ability to give you an answer. Okay, so don't be afraid. You know, it's only 8 diamonds. It's not going to break the bank, right? You're not going to have to take out a loan. But it could give you some clarity that might actually help you to make more money. You know, we can do career readings. Gaia career readings, you know. Not sure what to do about your future shop? Ask a question. We'll see. Okay, so what I want to work on today is where did I put all my red bricks? I had a bunch of red bricks. Now I don't have a bunch of red bricks. Where did I, there they are. All right, so I got a combination of all this stuff. I got green. What I want to work on today is I want to work on a meeting hall. Not a meeting hall, but a place where people coming to Gaia can conduct business, right? This is going to be a place of business. This is going to be sort of like, you know, the room in my in our market. It's going to be sort of like that, a little bit or a lot of bit like that, where we can sit down and hash out some deals, right? Because, you know, that's what we're about here in New Eden. People are going to be coming here to hash out some deals, so we're going to need a nice, peaceful, relaxing place to talk business, right? Makes sense to you, right? Makes sense to me. So that's what I'm going to build today. I'm not going to finish it or anything. I'm not even going to get close to finishing this thing. But it's going to work a little bit like the tarot, where it's going to butt into Mount Eden a little bit. We're gonna have a nice open space, so I'm gonna do like a waiting room and then a meeting room. So in case that they're, you know, I got multiple appointments, they can wait. They don't have to wait outside because there's actually a lot of mobs around here. I don't know why they like spawning on Mount Eden. I guess there's nowhere to spawn nearby, so they really accumulate on Mount Eden with all the skylights, which I need to fix. And so I don't want them waiting outside. So we'll do like a, give me that. We'll do a waiting room, and then we'll do a thingamajigger. Okay, I got some white wool here. Oh man, I need... Okay, I don't have all my materials with me. I need to get some nether quartz. I like to use nether quartz a lot. I like it a lot. It's one of my favorite blocks to use in survival. I mean, it's expensive, so there's some quartz stairs. This was all semi-organized, and then a creeper came and blew it all up. And I do mean all up. So now it's not as organized as it once was. Purple, green and purple. We also would like some yellow. Yellow would be nice. Don't think I have any yellow wool. I have to go buy some from Ro. Oh, I do have yellow wool. We got the new eating colors, but I don't have very much purple, though. I could use some more purple. I think there's some more downstairs, though. There's got to be more downstairs. At that. Well, we'll see. We don't know yet. We don't know yet. Let's go up, 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 up. I'm lazy. What can I say? I'm lazy. Oh, no. Oh, it's just laggy. What can I say, right? Alright, so we got colors. We got nether quartz. What should we do here? I'm thinking... So, it's purple on top. Yellow, green in the middle. And then yellow on the bottom. So, maybe if we did sort of like a New Eden flag rainbow. That could be something. That could be something. Let's see how we can do this here. I'm just spitballing here, guys. I just got the realization that none of this is going to get done. This is one of those, test it out, see how it looks sort of deals. So I'm not going to get anything done today. But at least you guys know what I'm working on these days. I'm really trying to get this city up and running. I want visitors, you know. A lot of the complaints by former leaders were that there wasn't enough community interaction. So... You know, we have the reputation here at New Eden for being shut off from everybody because we got the wall and we don't allow visitors. And so we definitely have a reputation for shunning visitors. But the whole reason I allowed that to happen on this server, I allowed New Eden to be so segregated, was because I knew that we were going to have this city. And so anyone could come visit this city, you know, if they wanted to see what we were doing. So it took me a whole year to really, I mean, all we had was the auction house. And so, you know, we did have a lot of visitors because of the auction house. But I want to give players more of a reason to visit New Eden so that we can start fostering community, right? These walls don't contain you in here. Hey. There we go. Okay, that could be cool. Then let me get that purple. Let me get that purple, y'all. Let me get that. Let me get that. Okay. That's what I'm thinking. Do I have enough? You never know. You never know. Hold on. Hold on. There we go. Do we? Yes, we got enough. Got plenty. What am I talking about? Let's make the... Oh. Let's make the jump. It seems like we've had our first death in the parkour. Besides myself. Xbox Man was trying it out and... He died, and he spawned far away, and he couldn't get to his stuff in time, so he lost a bunch of stuff. Buyer beware! Perform the BVP at your own risk, okay? He was kind of upset that there was no waivers signed, so that he felt that New Eden was culpable. But no way, we're taking... I mean, you parkour at your own risk. Okay, now what I want to do is get more... I want to bring that to the ground, is what I want to do. Oh, yeah, this is going to be epic. Any purple in here? Let's go down into the Enchanted Forest and see if there's any purple in there. There's got to be. Come on, perps. Down, down, down. Man, I hope I don't have to go back to Rigel and get purple. I mean, Rose got his wolf farm. I guess I could go... pilfer from there. You know, I leave money, though. I leave some money for him. You know what I'm saying? I just don't want to have to go all the way to Rigel. Come on, purple. I know you're in here. Come on, I can't sprint. There we go. Let's see. Purple. No. Purple. No. 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 Oh, there's one more option here. One more option before we really get too crazy about it. Let's gonna go. You're not supposed to look at this part. This is sort of the workman's alley. We're gonna go to the workman's part of town, but that's all right. You can see. I'll show you. What the heck? Oh, super lag!
Super duper lag.
Only in Gaia. Alright. Oh, you're not supposed to spawn here. Does that mean we need more lighting in here? More lighting around? I don't know where these things... Oh no, they spawn in any light level, so I don't know what the deal is. Alright, there's gotta be a purple in here. There's just gotta be. Yeah, this is the work area for New Eden. I've been working the live long day in here. Oh, this is exciting. Six? That's not gonna cut it. Six ain't gonna cut the mustard. Oh man, misclicks galore. Oh man. Oh well. I'll just have to go. I'll just have to go get some more. You would think, it being our national colors, I mean, there's purple everywhere. You'd think we'd have more of it on stock. I guess it's just, that's the problem, is I use so much of it. No, let's not go that way. That's not the way to go. Now we got this. This makes everything so much easier. Now New Edenites don't have to use the Enchanted Forest. It's beautiful. It's great. And whenever we feel like it, we can go up the Enchanted Forest, but we don't have to. So this saves a little bit of time. Booyah. All right, let's, use the purple we got, I guess, and then just imagine there's purple there. I'll put some dirt blocks instead, because I'm not going to spend time on this episode going to Rigel to get into purple blocks. No, thank you. No, thank you. Oh, I hate a cluttered inventory. Who doesn't? It's the worst. No, we're in the drink. We have to redo where. Okay, there we go. That's all purple. Use your imaginations. Purple. Okay. Alright, so we got that. That's that. I feel like we need a little bit more of that red trim. That brick seems like out of place a little bit. That's not supposed to be purple. The brick seems a little bit out of place now. Okay, let's put some stuff in this. Let's put this away. I don't want that. I don't want that. I don't want that. White. Okay, whatever. Don't need that. Some clay. Don't need that. Let's make a few of stairs. Let's make a few of slabs. See if we can accent a little bit. Maybe like that. How does that look? I mean, I got all those nether quartz too. Does not... That looks a little bit better. Hold on, it really covers the green though. The green doesn't really shine anymore. No, I don't like it. I don't like it. Oh, man. This is one of those episodes, guys. I'm sorry. From time to time, we have these episodes. You know, it wouldn't be survival if I wasn't building, too. I gotta build. Right? It can't be all progress. Let me check how much time we got in this episode. We may be running out. Let's see here. Yikes, we're out of time. Okay, so I got nothing done, as usual. As per the norm. Okay, we got nothing done, but we got it started, alright? So that's going to be the meeting hall. If you guys want to conduct business, then this is the place to come. He won't be here. Trust me, it'll be a safe place. We'll get rid of all the unwanteds when the time comes. Look at all this. Unwanteds everywhere. Yeah, get out of here. Give me your XP. All right, that's going to be the episode for today. I want to thank you guys for getting back in the swing of things with us here on the Gaia community server. It's things are running a lot smoother these days. We're a little bit smaller of a community, but we're tighter, we're more cohesive, we're more communicative, we're more interactive. We have ditched the dead weight. All right, so thank you guys for paying attention still on Gaia. Good things are happening. So that's going to be the episode for today. Subscribe if you haven't already. Leave a like if you enjoyed that. Happy Minecrafting.
Peace.